Today's an exciting day as we take a closer look inside RJ Corman's newest shortline railroad, the Raleigh and Fayetteville. Situated in Fuquay's Arena, North Carolina, the Raleigh and Fayetteville is RJ Corman's 19th operating shortline, having announced back in November of 2022 that they would be acquiring Norfolk Southern's VF line, with the effective takeover date being on December 17, 2022. This brings about a new change to the railroading scene here in central North Carolina as we welcome this brand new short line to the region. The Raleigh and Fayetteville operates a total of 63 miles of track, spanning from the capital city of Raleigh down to Fayetteville, North Carolina. As of now, the railroad serves a total of 5 customers and has interchange points with both Norfolk Southern and CSX. The railroad currently hosts 3 locomotives, including B39-8E number 8572, which used to reside on my hometown short line, the Nashville and Eastern. We will begin our day in Fuquay's Arena, watching the crew switch out cars in the yard before chasing them down to Lillington, North Carolina, and calling it a day from there. Meanwhile, the crew of RF-01 preps their locomotives for a long day of service working on the railroad. With the crew on board and ready to go, RF-01 begins to back up to the yard to pick up its cars for their trip south. With the crew still switching the yard, I decided to head over to my first spot of the chase along West Academy Street in downtown Fuquay Varina. And roughly 30 or so minutes later, RF-01 would emerge as they exit the yard with their four cars bound for the interchange in Fayetteville. The line having a speed limit of 10 miles per hour, it couldn't be easier to chase and move to your next spot. After my last shot, I quickly made my way over to Rawls Church Road, where I found myself with plenty of extra time to set up and wait for RF-01 to climb up the hill. We move down to the crossing at Chowibeat Road, where we see RF-01 slowly creep from underneath the tunnel of trees. To the left of us is RF-01's first customer of the day, the Harnett Transload Facility. The crew has been assigned to pick up two cars from Harnett, an empty center beam and an open hopper car. And in order to do so, they'll have to cut away from their train, roll back into the facility, pick up the cars, and place them at the front of the train. With the switch thrown, the crew runs light into the facility to pick up their new cars. After a couple minutes of switching harness, the crew returns with their new pickups, ready to place them at the front of their train. Once ready, the crew will notch up and get ready to get back on the pole again. I decided that my final shot of the day would be the Cape Fear River Bridge in Lillington, North Carolina. Given the beauty of the scene, it was a no-brainer to bookend the chase here. While times have certainly changed, I can only wonder what it must have been like to witness Baldwin Diesel's traverse over this bridge back in the day. The following day, I find myself on a whim in Glenwood Yard in Raleigh, North Carolina, once more seeking the Raleigh in Fayetteville. RFCC 3817 had finally made its way into Glenwood Yard as some RJ Corman members inspect the unit and prep it for service on the railroad. In the back, the crew of RF-01 inspects their own locomotives as they prepare to grab whatever NS sets out for them to take from the yard. NSP-59 can also be seen working Glenwood Yard, as they work to pull a cut of 5 loaded limestone gondolas meant for the Raleigh and Fayetteville to take south to Fayetteville. With P-59 clearing out of the way, the RF-01 crew can begin to roll their 2 locomotives back and onto the yard ladder. From there, they will roll up to track 2 to pick up their cut of cars from NS and prepare to head south with. Both crews exchange a few laughs as RF-01 readies to depart the yard and head south with their five cars. Boylan Bridge is a Raleigh favorite to both rail fans and tourists alike due to its wide open view of the city backdrop. This would be our last and final shot of the video as we wait for RF-01 to move south across the diamond. I hope you enjoyed this video exploring this exciting new short line. Expect some more videos from me covering this line in the near future. Until then, I'll see you in the next one.